Gee, Shrek, I tell you what, we are back and we are back at it. And where are we at today? We are at the Mindeleff Cavates. Cavates basically means a man-made cave. And so we're back. We've been here before, but I'm telling you what, it's the most spectacular, one of the most spectacular places ever. Easy for me to say, right? Last time we came down that ridge right there, okay? This time, we're going across the river. They say it's pretty difficult to get out of the river. I don't even know how deep it is. I'm packing everything up high. I got a backpack, which I normally don't take, but you know what? Today, I'm gonna go across because I know how treacherous it is coming down that ridge. Now, it was 100 when I left Phoenix, but it's 63 up here in Verde, Camp Verde. And it should be an incredible journey across the river. I feel like I'm maybe like one of the old, the camel guys, right? You know, they used to have that safari type deal. That used to be their gig. And I'm looking forward to this. This should be crazy. Cosmos Mindleff in 1895 came in here and he basically did all the excavation in this area of Arizona. All over this area and all the way down, you know, south and north, east and west. And he was the first guy that documented these caves. And a cavate basically means that it's a man-made cave. They dug these out. There's two layers of sediment. There's a hard level, two hard levels, and they found a nice soft area in between, and that's where they dug these holes to make their homes. And what a great place. We're gonna have a great time. It's gonna be an incredible journey. I'm glad to be back at it. It's 63 degrees. I don't know how cold the water is gonna be. And I don't know I don't know how cold it's gonna be. And I don't know how deep it's gonna be. So if you look right here, I've got my old shoes on. We're gonna clean them in the Dirty Verde, as they call it here. And I'm gonna pack it right up here. Got my 1983 pack, and I've got my new Hokas, and once we get across, we're going to dry off, and then we're hoping it's not too deep. I'm expecting maybe waist deep is what I'm expecting to get into, but who knows? Let's get on the trail. Let's see. Let's get into that Dirty Verde, if you know what I'm saying. I knew a Dirty Verde once, but it's another story for another time. Let's go take a look. Let's get in the river. As Jeff Williams says, and you're gonna get wet. Well, I am, at least you're not. You know, a lot of people wanna know where the antiquities went from this area. And some of these antiquities that are around are at the Fields Museum in Chicago. And so that's where Mindeleff, or Mr. Cosmos, as you used to say. Well, look at this right here. Maybe this isn't the best place to go down. Maybe we should go over there. That's quicker, but maybe not better. So let's go take a look. I hear some type of machines coming down the river. That ought to be awesome. So what a beautiful place this is. It's pretty incredible that this is a place that you can go. And when you get down here, and it's not a museum. You can come across as you want and just take care of it. Follow the signs. And it's just an incredible place, it really is. Maybe this is a little easier to get down. Yeah, I think it is. I think we'll take a journey over there, and I don't know what we're gonna get into when we get into the weeds over there. That could be a whole nother interesting journey in itself. So let's hope that the old Hokas, the mountain goats, and they did their job. So let's get back down here and see what we've got. Cosmos Mindeleff, where these cavates are named after. Now, he didn't name them the cavates. I believe that was Powell, General Powell, because he wanted to make sure that we understood that these were man-made caves. They were not natural. So, cavates means that, man-made. But Mindeleff, that is his last name. And Cosmos was down here with his wife, Marion, and they together excavated all kinds of ruins and did a hell of a job too. You can still see his documentation of all these. Now here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna try to figure out where we're gonna get out. That's gonna be more of the pr- problem that we have today is how are we going to get out? Because everything I've read says that getting in is pretty easy. Getting out is not very easy. So once we get a place where we think we can go in, I'm more concerned about a place where I think we can get out. And I don't know where in the hell that's at. It does look like somebody has broken brush over there. But then once you get out, I don't know what you're into when you get out. Well, that's why they say these are adventures. But you know what? I really thought the river was going to be down today. I really thought that it was not going to be as deep. I knew it was going to be cold, and it's cold. Let's see how deep I get into as I get in here. You know, I don't know. I'm going to try to get my pants up as high as I possibly can. I know they're going to get wet, but we're going to try it. I think right over there is where I'm going to try to go in. It's going to be a mess. I can tell you that already. It's going to be interesting. But we'll see. So what we're going to do is kind of guide for that over there. Well, here we go. I tell you what, there's only going to be one way to do this. And I just cranked my pants up. Now, all my keys and everything, I did think ahead. Everything's in plastic, so I don't know how high it's going to be. If it gets over my waist, I'm going to have to figure out a different plan on how I'm going to do this. But it's already deeper than I thought it was going to be. I can tell you that already. Now, I'm hoping that this is about as deep as it's going to get. But I'm afraid that that's not going to be true. So I'm already higher than I wanted to be. Whew, look how deep this is. I'm hoping it doesn't get any deeper. But I'm hoping. That about took me. The only thing I'm concerned about is my pack. So here's what we're looking at. Here's what we're looking at right here. I don't think Cosmo went this way. It does look like somebody's broken through over there. But just like I said, the only thing I'm concerned about is how deep it gets on my pack. It's actually getting a little deeper. It's almost at my pack. I'm on my tippy toes. But it should be, as rivers go, it should be getting up. And I should be coming out. The problem is, how in the hell do I get out of here? Here's what you're seeing. You're seeing the same wall I'm seeing. So the big deal is going to be is, how in the hell do we get out of here? And again, being conscious of our pack. So I understand now why, that gave me a heart attack. I thought that was a snake. So is there a better way if we walk on down as we get deeper and deeper and deeper and deeper? I'm about to the limit. I can't go any deeper this way. We might have to find a different route to get in to the river. Well, we thought this was going to be an adventure today, and it surely is an adventure. One of the positives we're dealing with right now is I know how deep the water is. It's cold, but it's not terrible. The bottom's fairly rocky, so that's not bad. I'm more worried about getting my pack wet than anything else. We go across here. The water's actually pretty clean. For the dirty Verde, it's not bad. I didn't expect, I was hoping that because it was still at the end of summer, that the water would be a little lower. So we're gonna have to look for a better avenue to get in. Now that was an adventure so far. I kept my water. I don't see any areas over there to get through. So we're gonna have to find a better area to jump on. So that's one of the reasons that maybe you wanna come from the top, right? Is to make it a little easier. It's a little brisk out here now that I'm soaking wet. But went up past my belt, so it's more higher than your waist. I mean, I'm halfway up my chest. I kept my pack dry, and that's all that really matters, with my goodies in it. So we'll have to see where that comes in. And they did say it was not an easy place to cross as far as getting out on the other side, which probably helps the area. Another option would be go down to the ramp. There's a creek that flows down there, and that might be a better option still. But we haven't got across this thing yet. Well, we got across, but we didn't get in. So let's see what we got in store for us right here. I do not see anywhere there's a break. In the brush. I really thought this was going to be a hell of a lot easier coming across here than it has been. If I'd have known I had this, I would have brought a machete. You just don't know what you're getting into when you get over there. Well, here we go. We're going to try this dude again. I've got to figure out how I'm going to do it. Got my microphone high, so I can't get over that. I've got this pack I'm going to carry over my head like this. So here we go. And then the only thing I got to worry about is not getting this mic and my camera. And hopefully I got good balance going in here. That's the other thing. Kind of a ledge when you walk off in here. And then when we get over there, I'm not even sure we can still get it done, but we are going to, I didn't want to get my belt wet, but I should have thought about that a long time ago. Now, where was the slot I was going to try to slide in at? That'd be the only other thing right now, is I can't see where I was going to go in. I mean, there's a couple places where you see, like, it looks like somebody went through. I'm thinking maybe I didn't see the right area. Water should get a little heavy in the water. It's an interesting journey. So far, the journey's been getting over there. So maybe once I do it, you guys will realize that this was either stupid or smart if you know where to get in, and maybe I can help you, because there's the stairs. So that'd be a good way to say, hey, go through there. But I'm not even sure what I'm going to get into. I can't see over there. I got the sun coming into my eyeballs. Again, I don't know what I'm going to get into once I get over there. Maybe one, but I don't, I mean, it's not getting wet. It's just ruining equipment. That's the only thing I don't want to do. Tell you, that looks like a good place as any right there to go in and get up. I got a feeling it's going to be deeper because we're in an area where the water is, the lane's a little more narrow, and I'm going to guess that that means that it's deeper. Now, I wouldn't be mad if I'd be totally wrong and it was more shallow. But once I start over, I got to get in because I can't hold this up over my head that long. So, biggest trick now is don't fall. Don't fall down. So, take it easy, ease in. Got my microphone riding high. The problem is I can't see till I get in the shade. Oh, that's the problem right there. Boy, once you get going, you gotta be committed to go across that. Okay, I can go that high. Oh, that microphone ain't gonna make it. I've got to even go higher. Man, this is not easy. Well, we try again. I knew I was going to go under, though. Probably neck high. Down here where I thought it was deep, really wasn't even deep. Just it wasn't any way to get out of here. We cut this thing about 15 different ways on how we're going to get across here, and I got a place right there. It looks like somebody has broken the grass right through there. It looks like somebody's went through there. I don't know what you get into. You get a bunch of nasty weeds, I know that. A day that if I had to do it over again, I would have probably brought a pair of pants. Man, the brush looks just heavy. We're going to try it one more time. And or then we'll just go to the top and swing around and cut it again. But I'm going to put all my pack above my head and see if we can't get this thing done, man. Whew. So let's kind of get in through here, get in this dirty Verde, and see what this dirty girl's got for us. You know, I freaked out down there a little bit because I kept going down, but here I kind of know what I got. I don't even know how in the hell I'm going to get through there once we get going. But it's a little deeper on the other end, but it looks not bad over here. I don't think I'm going to have to worry about that. It's more about how in the hell do I get out of there. I see a little space. It looks like maybe I can go up there, but once I get up there, I don't even know what the hell I'm getting into either. I got a shore or a bank that I'm going to try to get up. A lot of rocks. The water is going to get a little deeper, and then it's going to get a little, we're going to go up a little bit. But we're going to have to crawl out of this thing, man. I'm going to give you guys a view of what we're getting into now so you can see what we're getting into. So I don't even know how in the hell we're going to get out of here once we get in here. And it's getting sticky muddy too. Not just muddy, but sticky muddy. Man, I don't think I can crawl through there. And then when you do, it's so solid. Is it better over here? Kind of looks like somebody broke that down at one time. But boy, I'm in the nasty mud in here. I don't even know if we can get through there. Man, I'm getting in trouble in here with this mud. Well, we're going to try a different way. Got something in the water in front of me. Hope it ain't a snake. Rattlesnakes do swim, if you didn't know. I don't know if they can bite you in the water, but they sure can't swim. I'll tell you what, my arm's about ready to fall off. Whew. didn't really want to crawl through that thicket, to be honest with you. I don't mind a little action and a little adventure, but I really didn't want to. I might just start trying to crawl through here and then come back across and pick up my gear, because well, I said it was going to be an adventure today. I thought the adventure was going to be on the other side of the creek. I didn't really think the adventure was going to be just getting over there. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to see if I can't find a better place to cross without all my crap, and then go from there. Yes, that slimy mud, like Missouri mud. Missouri River mud. I've been in Missouri River mud. You can sink 3-4 feet. It's that nasty. And then that suction doesn't allow you to want to get your boot out of there. So I've experienced that. That wasn't as bad as Missouri mud, but still it was like where I needed to get traction, I couldn't get any traction. Well, you guys wanted an adventure today, and I've definitely got one. I definitely got more of an adventure than I really thought. I thought the biggest deal I was going to deal with today was just getting wet, you know, and not getting anything else wet. I didn't realize that getting out of that. Now, I did read that, so I should make sure that it said, I saw notes that said, this is difficult to get across. So once I do it, and then let's see if I'm at the right place, then maybe it'd be a hell of a lot easier for you guys when you come here. Because I got a feeling, I mean, it's gonna get cold, and it would be difficult to go through this river when it was cold unless you had a kayak or something. But in the summer or even now, it's actually pretty pleasant to get in it. Well, I'll tell you what a great day to be hiking across the river. This is what you did in the old school. You know, once I found the right place, it wasn't that difficult. But boy, finding the right place was not easy. So the only thing we got to do is make sure that when we get out of here, I mean, we've still got to, it does look like people have went this way. Look at the, it looks like a trail right there. So it does look like people came out that way, but how in the hell do I make sure that I know which one it is when I come through here? Because it's going to be a little more interesting dropping in. My gut tells me this is our journey right through here. So this is what you got coming across. Again, if I'd have known the right way to go through and found the right path, it would have been so much easier. This doesn't look bad once you get out of here, but I got to figure out how do I mark where I came in at? Because that's going to be, it's going to be the key. To make sure I mark as I come through here. See how easy it is once you get up here? You know, once you find the right place. So there's the point right there. See that point? I'm going to remember that we split this valley right here when we get ready to get out of here. It's actually incredible. It really is not, you know, now I'd say if you're going to do it, do it. OK. Okay, what I see too is the only yellow flowers I really see on this wall sticking out is right there. So hopefully that's a reminder. And it almost looks like those are the tallest trees. And then I know I'm right straight square with this valley, that V right there on this end. That's the southern end of the Cavates right there. Now I don't know how difficult it's going to be to go across this, because there is remnants of a pit house somewhere through here. And I think once I get over here, if you can look at the Cavates right there, you can imagine what it felt like when Cosmos and Marion came through here with all the antiquities intact and all this unbelievable area, this lost civilization. Just think what they would have thought. You know, what are these caves? What is this? Now, a lot of times people don't realize within these caves, they actually had mortar type dividers in them. So it wasn't just like, you know, just a big open room. They actually divided these out, made it a home. Tell you what, this little valley is kind of interesting. It's really intriguing. It's going to be hopefully not difficult to maneuver back through. Hopefully it'll be easy, but I've never come this way. A lot less than I dreamed that we were going to get into here. The Mindeleff Cavates. And remember, we're in a place that is extremely sacred, but the reality of this is, what's beautiful is, look how many people are here today. No one's here but us and the great spirits. So what we're going to do is, when we get closer, we're going to get dried off, change some of the gear, and then get onto this excavation. But look at this, isn't this incredible? Look at this place. Over 300 rooms here. They said about 300 people lived here, but you know, it's gonna be difficult to find our way back over there, isn't it? I don't think super difficult, but it's not gonna be a piece of cake. But you know what, we made it over here. Now we get to explore one of the most unique ruins in the state of Arizona. This is not the only cavate, but I believe this is definitely the largest. How incredible is this? It's amazing to come in through this direction. Now, that's not the top of the mountain right there. That's the top of the ridge. The top of the mountain is way up another couple levels. So when you climb out of here, you have a lot of climbing to do. It's not as easy as it might seem. We got fence here. See, I didn't see any of this stuff last time that we came through here, because we weren't at the bottom. Look at this gate. This is awesome. This is pretty incredible. I'm digging it right now. It's the way it's supposed to be right here. This is exactly the way it's supposed to be. It's telling me that there's bats. It's telling me that we need to take care of this place so we can all enjoy it. It's telling me don't keep it secret. It's telling me to have fun, but it's not telling me that you can't come see it. And that's what I like about this. And again, last time we came on that ridge from above, so we didn't see any of these signs. Because most people, I take it that most people don't go across the river. But I tell you what, now that we found an easy way to get across the river, that's definitely the way to go. Here's another sign telling us to. Now, see, I hate when I see these shards stacked. I hate that. Don't stack them. Touch them, feel them, leave them where they're at. Don't stack them. It's kind of crazy. Let's find a rock and let's change our shoes. And then let's get this adventure going, man. Tell you what, I'm pretty stoked. Now, there's cavates, houses, all the way across these ridges. And then even up there, way up high. It's an incredible place. And if you get a chance to come see this, you should. The Verde Valley is absolutely stunning. It is stunning. And the Verde Valley people, the older people, the newer people are a little bit put off, I think. But the older people love to have people come see this stuff. Maybe they too much wreckage. But what an incredible place to go. Probably take the sunglasses off, switch to the regular glasses, and see what this journey, this adventure of Mindeleff Cavates. You know, Cosmos was an incredible guy. He really took this serious. Before, archaeologists were more like treasure hunters in a sense. And he did a great job at documenting every one of these homes. What an incredible life this would have been up here. Again, you have your main staple, which is food, right? Water. So if you got water, you got food, because you can grow crops and then you're gonna have animals because they have to drink, they have to do the same thing. So what a great place for you to be able to go into and really experience this. So we're gonna get changed, get some dry shoes on. We're not gonna dry off anything else. We're gonna air dry the rest of the body. And I think we got a great place for you guys to be able to come in. And I feel good about that. Now, I had to do some journey work for you guys, but overall, wow, what a beautiful place this is. It's incredible. This is absolutely incredible. This is what history is really all about, is going out. And I love to talk about it. I love our Tuesday shows, but I love to get the experience to come out here and go, wow, what would it have been like to live here? I mean, what would the quality of life been here versus other places? But, let's get ready. Let's go do this. Let's go do this.